This right here is the Bambu Labs A1. It's a $350 3D printer if you buy the standalone kit, but if you buy the combo, then it's gonna cost you another $150. So all in all, in total, you'd have to spend $500 to get this setup that I got here. What actually got me interested in trying this printer out was to see how easy it is for a beginner to get started with 3D printing. The first 3D printer that I bought was a FlashForge Adventurer 4. And I remember that being incredibly finicky to get started with, and I was never really satisfied with the prints that were coming out of that. Then I had a friend tell me about a new brand that was called Bambu Labs, and that they had just dropped a state-of-the-art 3D printer that was called the X1C, which is kind of similar to the printer that I got right here that is called the X1E. The biggest difference between the X1E and the X1C is that the E stands for enterprise version. It basically allows you to print a couple of more materials and higher nozzle temperature, higher bed temperature, and also the possibility to connect your printer through an Ethernet cable instead of relying on Wi-Fi. But when I started to use my X1C, I also realized how freaking simple Bambu Labs had made 3D printing for anyone to get started with. But the price point of the X1C at around $1,000 is still a little bit too steep for most people to actually get into 3D printing. And that is why I want to try the A1. So the entire setup process of the A1 is incredibly simple. You don't need to have any sort of prior experience to be able to set this up and actually get started with your printing. So the first time that you're booting your printer up, you need to run an auto calibration on the unit, which is basically gonna give you a vibration compensation. It's gonna calibrate the X, Y, and Z axis on the plate and the tool head so that everything is leveled and perfectly ready to print. And you don't have to think about doing all the fine-tuning adjustments and going into any sort of software. Everything is just there for you to press the button, and then it does it by itself. It's almost exactly the same kind of calibration that you run on the X1C as well. If you're looking into buying the A1, you have two different options. One is to, of course, purchase a standalone model, which is basically just gonna give you the printer. But the second option is to purchase the combo version that I got right here, which includes the AMS. AMS stands for Automatic Material Switcher. And I don't know about you, but I think that this looks freaking awesome. It looks like a movie prop from the future. But what the AMS does is that it allows you to have several different filament spools attached at the same time to your printer. Say, for example, that you want to print a multicolored print, then you can attach four different colors to the AMS slots. Or if you're printing multiple different things in multiple different materials and you want to have an easy access to all those materials without having to switch out the filament rolls every single time. This one is called the AMS Lite. There is two bigger ones that is called the AMS and the AMS 2 Pro. The biggest difference is that the AMS for my X1C is an enclosed unit. This one here is an open one. And the reason that you want to have an enclosed AMS is mainly because filaments tend to attract moisture over time. So if you have your filament spools like this, then over time it might affect the quality of your print because of your filament spools getting a little bit more moisturized. But I mean, like, I've had this hanging here with filament spools now for a little bit over 2 months. And there's nothing to worry about. Now, the biggest question that I usually get whenever I talk about 3D printing is, what kind of filament should you use when you get started? It actually kind of depends on what it is that you want to do, but to get started with something easy and simple, I'm gonna say that PLA is probably going to be your best bet because it's simple, it's sturdy, and it doesn't give you a lot of fumes from the melting plastic that something like ASA, would give you. But there's a bunch of different filaments that you can use for different kinds of purposes. PLA, for example, is great to have as the brackets that I got on my desk
that is holding my iPad in place or my keyboard in place or my laptop or even the camera mount that is holding this camera on my IKEA Scordis board.
So the first thing, in my opinion, that you should do when you get a 3D printer is to download some prints that is already made. And that is where MakerWorld comes into play. MakerWorld is basically this big community that Bambu Lab has created so that people can upload their own models and their own print files so that you can download them to your own printer and print them at home. And it just makes the entire world of 3D printing so much simpler because now you don't have to design each and every print on your own that you might want to print at home. And just to give you an example, I needed to have a couple of hangers for my headphones so that I could put them up to my Scordis board. So what I did was that I opened the Bambu Handy app, I searched for Scordis headphones, and then I went into the model that I liked, and I pressed prepare print. And here you can actually choose the printer that you want to print on. I'm gonna choose the A1. I'm gonna print that plate. We're gonna hit next. And we're gonna choose the replicator. And from that, you're gonna be able to print this on this without having to do anything. Start print. And it's sending the print file to the printer via the cloud so that I don't have to do any designing or anything at all because someone has already designed the print so that I can just download it and get started.
Ah! It just starts. There's so many different things that you're gonna be able to find on MakerWorld, which makes 3D printing fun without even knowing how to design stuff. And I remember when I started my 3D printing journey, I had no knowledge of how to design stuff, but I also didn't know about MakerWorld at the time, which made it very hard for me to actually print something useful. Now, you can print pretty much anything that you find on MakerWorld on your own printer. And since the quality of the prints that is coming out of the A1 is top tier, you're gonna start thinking about all the different things that you can optimize with 3D printing. Maybe I'm just talking for myself here, but it's so much fun. So after using the A1 consistently now for a little bit more than 2.5 months, I can say that I'm having a very hard time telling apart the prints from the X1E, which is a $3,000 printer, from the A1, that is a $350 printer. They look almost identical, and I usually prefer to print on this one rather than the X1E, mainly because I think it's fun to print on this because you can see the process more. And the biggest drawback of it is probably that it's not an enclosed unit, so it's a little bit louder than the X1C, but it's also the only drawback that I've found. So if you're not looking into printing super high-end materials or you need to have the highest of specs on your 3D printer, then I gotta say that this printer makes it as easy as it's probably gonna get to get into 3D printing. And if you're looking into buying one, I can highly recommend you to get the AMS Lite, mainly because it's so much better to have 4 different spools of filament loaded rather than just one. And it also looks freaking amazing when you have it hanging on the wall, just like I did. And the mount that is actually holding the AMS, that's also 3D printed from MakerWorld. Kinda sick, right? Anyway, I would love to know what you thought about this video, and if you're going to buy the A1 or if you have any other questions about 3D printing, do drop them in the comment section down below. I can drop a link to the 3D printer in the description. Head over there, check it out, and thanks for watching this video. Don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you want to see more of this. Peter Fransvoude is saying goodbye.